there have been art trails elsewhere, elephants, pigs, in New York, London, other things. And they said, well, we could we do a kind of Wallace and Gromit one? Could we use Gromit and do a Gromit Unleashed, which is, as you say, these big models of Gromit which have been painted up. Phenomenally successful, way, way beyond our expectations. And we had a fantastic summer, lovely weather. Millions of people seemed to come to Bristol to look at them. And it literally, I think it took everybody by surprise how successful it was. I think Bristol in particular, because they really take Wallace and Gromit to heart. I think the Children's Hospital had hoped that overall it'd raise about £1 million, which would have been great. £1 million for the hospital for kind of a summer event.
So all proceeds went to
went to the Children's Hospital. At the end of the day, they raised over £3.5 million. I think the total after the auction, everything else is added up, it was pushing like £5 million, which was absolutely staggering. Brilliant. Absolutely staggering. The charity is doing the same thing again this year, 2 years later, but featuring Shaun. Shaun in the City, as it's called.
That's why I saw a few Shauns when I
walked
in.
That's right. So those are some that are being painted here. So it's a tale of two cities, London and Bristol, an event happening in London, and then they'll come to Bristol. It links in with Green Capital, of course, so that should be fun.
Also this year, there's an exhibition that's happening.
That's right, Art Ludique, which is a big art gallery, and they've done exhibitions with Miyazaki, Pixar, Marvel, and it's about art. It's about the art of particularly animated films. So they've asked us to do one for them, The Art of Aardman. We're shipping out 32 sets and literally hundreds of artwork, a lot of it in digital form, a lot of it originals, to show the range of the art that we do, that our artists do, that our designers do, that our model makers do. I'm very excited by it because I think it's the first time anybody will see all that stuff sort of in one place at any one time. It's a vast collection. It's made us dig deep into the archives, which has been wonderful.
It must be a huge space that they're
it's a pretty it is a pretty big space. It's I can't remember how, but it, you're looking at something like, is it 5,000 square meters, 50,000 square feet? It is quite a big space. But that it's a great opportunity because actually you kind of forget over the years all the stuff that we've done and actually all the work that's gone into thinking about the films or thinking about even designs for commercials. So a lot of original stuff that shows you the thinking process of getting to the final result. A lot of model sets, particularly from the recent films that we've made. A lot of artwork actually, which may have been done for pictures that never normally sees the light of day, and certainly in the public eye, which is fantastic, just the range of work. And I think it's an expression of gratitude to all the artists and creatives that we've used over the years. It's sort of their exhibition. You know, we have been the catalyst to get all this work made and created, but it's all these other people that have actually done the work, and I think it's a great celebration of their work.